Or maybe not, because we're back on camera. One prediction. We can now do predictions before we get into the game with
Trouble.
Yeah. So he is just gonna
finish him.
He's not gonna go for flank. So the consensus, maybe they want to try to go for an earlier Roshan as well. But the thing is, they're almost out of smokes, if not completely out. So if that's the case.
Oh, nice back.
Radiant's bottom tower has fallen.
First blood.
Spent his money. So I think that rotating that many people, getting the tier 1, now CDEC are going to have a chance to counterplay themselves. They can pressure the alternate tier 1 of Secret. I mean, obviously giving away the first blood itself isn't great, and Secret are going to smoke up here and potentially look for an engagement. Oh, is Q going to break this?
Secret, they've had a taste for blood here, and they want to try and find more puppet. He wants the XE. He should be fine. He's got another time warp coming straight back up. And Annihilation as well, really screwing over Secret as they're unable to follow through with any further spells. But another kill on the board, and 2-0 now for Secret. One of the kills that count here, and they're starting to win these skirmishes that... So it seems to be CDC just getting caught up to CDC. It could be their turn to get the kill on the board. They've got the Dream Coil, they've got the Chronosphere, and Garda will have the Laguna back up in about 10 seconds here. Misery standing there in the front of this one. There'll be the Blink Force from Shiki. The hand forward, the time from XD. They're holding onto their ults here, waiting for the right time. They get the time dilation onto Misery. And Misery, he'll go for the TP out, but Lina's there with a Light Strike. They will take down the Fury and the BM Laguna Blade to finish it off. Garda desperate to use his ultimate. And aggressive, he's going to try for the TP out, but there's a snowball there. Secret, they're ready for the counter attack, and aggressive once again, getting caught out fairly deep on Secret's territory there.
It's a trade one for one, but obviously aggressive is worth a little bit more. I'm really actually impressed with the way that Secret have been playing this, because first off, Misery runs towards the enemy tower, realizing that there's two big AoE ulties off cooldown. If I run into my team, it's probably going to result in multiple heroes dying instead of just me. So I'm just going to attack
all Envy.
Envy.
Oh,
the neutral killed him.
Oh!
Losing the Ancients probably makes it still better. But overall, I think that Secret have been playing it very nice so far.
Oh, my.
No shadow.
That's for your impertinence.
Come get healed. Radiant's middle tower.
On top of that might be. This game starting to see a little bit of action. And in the meantime, this guy, Aggressive, so we're gonna see a smoke up in Secret as well. There's just been everyone's fighting, Aggressive's farming. Like, that's his role
he
right
is
now.
Keeping up there. We on his OD is really catching up, though. He's less than 1k behind.
Oh, he's
they're gonna go for it here. But, oh, here comes the creep! Oh, he's spotted!
Zap!
Yeah, they've got a good lineup for this one. XD is getting, does not have Chrono Fear, and it's gonna be down. OD's gonna be able to pick himself up the Aegis, and now with the snook! Just onto Odin.
Now, with a mech on Puppy as well, like, he's gonna be guarding Grease about 1250 gold. This is the kind of momentum that Secret are looking for.
Quite an awkward combination, but a lot of teams are liking it.
I think it's main. Oh.
Misery. He managed to run away from two of these so far. I don't think he's gonna run away from this third one. The Stonelock is there, the Silence as well. Misery getting bursted down from the two of them. Kiki will take the kill. We are. Maybe see if you'll find anything on the. On the counter here, Aggressive, he's duking it out into the jungle. He has got the favorable movement speed, so he should be able to get himself away. Pilot dive
so
closing
fast.
In as well.
The tree
nearly blocks him out. We'll kind of force him to go to the north. We are desperately trying to look at the Asphalt, but he's not able onto Shiki here, but Shiki has got the ult to get himself out. We are still desperately chasing the Sven. Prince has kind of body block him up a little bit at the end, and looks like they won't find the lucky evil. Now, Q, he's got the heal here. Bench, pretty good hero this patch. Is he good enough? There's three heroes trying to take him down. Q on the run, Puppy, Firelight, but at the same time, Anthem, he's been caught.
drums, a little bit of mana.
I mean, drums and your war part stacking up, you're going to be racing around that. Yep. And I think that was the issue there. They just didn't have enough control, which is funny enough when you look at the heroes that they've got.
Oh,
I feel that Cheeky indeed getting caught out here, and he's gone. We are a few slaps with the orb, and that orchid is done. I believe they're also going for the orchid here on the nature, but yeah, they've got the double orb.
But if you mana burn him and he's not able to spam quills and goo, he's just like a creep, right?
It's true.
He doesn't really do that much, but I think most of it is just for the orchid.
Well, I'm in the moment. Secret can look for the second tier two. Well, beginning at this point. Got it. I was looking for a bit of pushing. Having a TP back. Is he jumping in a proper corner? Well, this fucking Weehaw. Weehaw caught a very vulnerable position here. CDC trying to bring him down in world, although taking now he's still got the Aegis. Dream of Bottles to regret. He's trying to do that in front. The Rostadum will survive. Envy as well gets the TP off, which is good as well, because he is stockpiling a lot of gold. That bristle. 3 point ridiculous cooldown spell there. 5 seconds every three. Get a few of those off with the mana pool that this creep rocks, and here we go. Smoke up from CDC. They've got all the ults available.
Oh, there's a double damage too.
I love it. Unfortunately, Zero Chance nearly alive here. Bit of potentially being an objective for CDC to go for. They do want to try and find the kills, but
they're going to
claim very safe.
They need to cut top because they have a ward, right? So they scouted out that Envy was up there, and they know that Misery might be in the area. I think it's the best chance for them to find something. They did get a ward down in the jungle too, so even if the smoke doesn't necessarily get a kill, it's going to be used for vision, and then Secret are going to have to try to find out where CDC actually placed those, which can be difficult.
As pings on Wii, they might want to jump this. They might want to just dive the CS2 and they can go in! Get the top!
About at the beginning of the game, they have one hero blink in, he coils and gets the silence, and then they go for the OD after the spear comes out from XD to make sure that there can be no grave. So the execution of that teamfight from CDC was flawless. Like, they just blew everything into Wii. They didn't have buyback on either of their cores. Like, Envy and Wii both couldn't buy out. I think this is just rad.
This was a major blow here for Secret that last minute of gameplay. And they've been going to stop it. Puppy trying to come out. They can still out to the face, but CDC able to get all the space that they need for those melee racks, and they're unable to do anything to try and catch them out on the way out. Very clean fight.
We are in a horrible spot.
Yeah, here we go, straight away. They know that they need to try and find something at this point. Misery will be spotted out by that ward, but the smoke was done away from any sort of vision from the side of CDC. They'll go straight for the pit. They've already sent the kinds. They know the CDC is still outside, and they're going to check in their own jungle. XE and Q are the two hard targets to lock down and find, and XE straight away with the TP out. He's going to be able to make it here. He's fine. He's out back to base, and Q as well. Did he get a range off?
Did he get stuck in animation because of Untouchable?
Either way, it's maybe a plus difference, but they're going to try and go for Roshan off back to sending those two high bars. CDC, they're going to be more than happy to fight now. They've got Bruno.
Against this team. Like, you have to worry about foil. The support phase. base, drop a Waning Rift, you know, throw an orb, dagging him, make him use all of his cooldowns on himself, because again, opening up kills on Core is really important.
He has been caught out here, the Laguna actually moving to the front here, the input is coming from behind, the stable will come out,
Thanks. Radiant structures are fortified.
Yeah, they can just go for more here. Onto the tier 3, and at this point, game 1 of this best of 3 series, looking to go very well for CDC, and I can't but feel that Secrets, they've got to try something different next game against this team.
I don't think their strategy was necessarily bad, and in fact, I would say for like the first 10 to 15 minutes, it felt like Secrets' game to me. I think the biggest problem that they had was after they got that Roshan, they didn't do anything with it. That was one of the biggest issues, is as soon as they go for that tier 2 dive, the OD dies, we bait this team into a fight that they pretty much just get wrecked in. And then after that, the one blink initiation when they were inside of the base, and that smoke that CDC did.
Trap isn't there for Secret. Do you feel that this was just CDC playing better, or do you feel that this was Secret making mistakes?
Well, their lineup is more prone to... They have to execute flawlessly, almost, with their lineup. So if you want to say that's a downside, then I think that's a fair argument. Like, Secret's lineup, they need to play extremely well against...